here with Kat Kerr, and Kat has brought a great technique for creating textured backgrounds. And these are absolutely amazing. I mean, the possibilities of what you can do are really great. And that's just by mixing various things into resin,
right? That's right. Sky's the limit. I mean, you can leave it plain if you want to, or you can add dyes to it, metallic powders. You can just use acrylic paint. I threw glitter in there. I threw just powders in that last one for a nice matte finish. There's tons of ways to use this stuff.
I'm so excited. But how do we actually start off this process?
Okay, well, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to actually mix up two equal parts of the casting resin. And so I already have one poured out here, and I'm just going to pour out the second one. And you do need two equal parts. So
I'm
just kind of eyeballing it. Yeah, it doesn't have to be science or anything like that. And so you do have to work quickly because this stuff, it cures really fast. And so I'm going to go ahead and pour one into the other. It's a little cloudy at first, but once it starts to clear up, I'll go ahead and pour it on top of this embossing folder that I've already taped down.
So I would like to point out that A, that was really fast, which I find surprising. But B, isn't that going to ruin your embossing folder?
Oh, no, it is not. It is going to peel off completely. It's not going to damage it.
So you haven't pre-treated this with anything?
Nothing,
absolutely. You just pour it directly on there. And you're working on top of wax paper,
obviously. Paper, right. And so normally it takes about 10 minutes to cure.
Okay.
But I already have some that's ready here.
So
we'll move this over to the side. And when it cures, it comes out as thin or as thick as you want to pour it. So this is like a sheet of plastic.
Not only that, but one of the things that's fascinating is if you look at these two pieces, because embossing folders have two different sides, usually a side that pushes in and a side that pushes out, you actually get two different patterns.
That's right. It's awesome.
I mean, double for the
price of one. Why not? And so I want to go ahead and add some texture to the outside of this mini shadow box. I'm not going to measure. I'm not big on measuring. So what I like to do is I'll just take this sheet, just hold it up against this little shadow box shrine
here. If you wanted to trace that, could you use a pen to write on this?
Oh,
can you write on this surface?
You can. I mean, it's slick, so you can use, you know, a permanent marker or something like that. But yeah, you can absolutely do that.
Just for people who are more careful. Not anybody here, of course, but, you know, somebody who might be.
And you see, it's pretty easy to cut. And so I normally like to go ahead and cut all of my sides out, and then I'll just cover the entire surface with the resin sheets.
And how do you attach it?
I'll go ahead and take some just matte medium. I'm pretty generous with it.
And you could use any gel medium. It doesn't have to be a matte one.
Absolutely.
You could use a gloss medium.
Whatever you have on hand is good.
Probably a heavier one. I'm guessing something a little thicker.
Something, you know, any, it's going to work for you. And so I'll just go ahead and put that off to the side and cover all of the sides.
Now, if we were going to mix in like the paint or the dye or anything that we were talking about before, you would do that in the cup before you poured, or you would do it after the pour?
You would do it before.
Okay.
It comes in a two-part system, and so you would actually put...
I'd throw my glitter directly into the cup, and then I would pour.
That's right. Okay. That's right. And so now I'm preparing the surface for the next step, which is just painting, and I'm just adding some gesso to it.
Okay. For people who don't know what gesso is, what is it?
It's just a primer. It prepares the surface for the paint that you're going to add to it.
It gives it gription.
Yeah, and especially because the resin is a little slippery, and so you want to use that gesso. And so this one's already, it already has gesso on it, and I'm going to go ahead and just take an acrylic paint.
And you're not cleaning your brush, and you're taking your time.
Yeah.
And I think there are a lot of different ways you could paint this. Now, you're obviously using a very thick coat, but you could certainly, you know, use a thin coat, use many colors, paint a pattern.
Sky's the limit.
Lots
with this
of other
stuff.
Choices. Go in a couple different layers.
Right,
and the
right.
nice thing about using a box is the way that you're holding it, because you only have to cover those exposed sides, you can get your hand into it.
Oh, yeah.
Are you worried at all about getting paint on the inside of it?
No, not at all, because I'm going to actually cover the inside with some paper. So this one's already dry. I went ahead and already added some just cardstock to the inside. I have one last strip to put on here, so I'm just going to take a glue stick and I'll just put it on the inside.
So when you're home, do you really just sort of like smear it on, throw it in there, don't think about it too much?
I don't think about it at all.
Why don't you use a wet adhesive there? Why do you choose a glue stick?
You know, to be honest, I think it's faster. It's not as messy as using a wet one, so it works good for me, but everybody has their own preference. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish up the outside of this with some metallic wax. And this is really, it's really smooth, and it's going to highlight all of those textures.
This and is a all great of that... way to bring out the texture. I love it.
Mm-hmm. And so I'll do that to all the sides.
When you're gluing this on, I never really did ask about this, but I'm wondering, do you worry at all about, like, does this square match this square?
Or
you're just throwing it on there?
Not at all. I mean, you can if you want to, but it's, you know, I'd rather just go ahead and have fun. And so one of the final things I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this white pen and just add some decorative element to the box
drawing
itself.
I can do. I like it.
Yeah, and it just adds a little bit of extra. And so this one is all ready to go. And you can leave this box just the way it
is. This wax, it's dry. Like, it's not going to come off on your hands.
Yeah, it takes a couple minutes for it to dry. In the beginning, it moves a little bit.
And it looks to me like you've also added some of the wax on the inside of the box.
I did. And what I did in that case is I just actually wet the brush a little bit. I dipped it into the wax and just put it on the inside to give it that nice final touch. And so, again, you can keep it like that. Or you can decide to put the smaller one into a larger shadow box if you want to.
How did you do the background of this box?
Same exact way that I did the smaller one. I added some casting resin to an embossing folder, added gesso, painted it the same exact way.
And instead of lining this box with paper on the inside, you painted it, and it looks like the outside of the box has paper.
That's right. And so it just gives it a little bit more interest. And I could finish this piece up by taking a little resin piece. I can glue it in the inside. I can also take just a sticker and put it on the bottom of that and add some rub-ons. And then I can just glue that one right to the center of that.
And again, you're keeping everything consistent by adding the same gold distress field.
Right.
I think it's funny that we're calling gold distress. But you're adding gold distress, right, to the resin cast piece that's in there, the gold wings. And this is something that I bet other people didn't realize. You've actually added some dimension onto everything with some foam adhesive, which really, again, lifts it and elevates it out of the box. Now, how do you choose your words and phrases and stuff like that? Like I say, it says this day. Does that mean something to you?
I definitely wanted to, I want the person to look at it and feel something when they look at my artwork. But definitely when I was making this piece, it was all about enjoying the moment. So that's why I picked
this day.
This day, right then and there. Yeah. And so I did make some other ones using the same exact technique with the backgrounds. And, you know, the great thing about these sheets is that you can use them on canvases, on journal covers, in all different ways.
Well, I was going to say, this shadow box that's here, I particularly like the way that there's a face, because that looks to me like an image that might be out of a vintage magazine or something like that. But you could use the face of someone you know to personalize it. And she's wearing a lovely necklace and all that kind of stuff.